So moving into the scheduling person, let us see what his responsibilities are. So this is a relatively, I won't say a new position, but it's a position which is becoming more and more and more critical because the time constraint of the project is more. So if you go to today's projects, you will find that we talked about earlier, people need to know, people need to have knowledge and experience to be able to manage large projects. But today there are so many large projects that a person out of college with very, very little experience, with very you know, basic knowledge, gets put in as the scheduling engineer. Okay, so you really have to learn a lot on the job. And if you take the responsibility of the scheduling engineer, okay, this is a lot of text on this, but let us just see. It's a lot of work. It is to look, initial job planning, scheduling of time, scheduling of materials, coordination of subcontractors, monitoring of job progress, analysis of change, problem solving. Okay, when I take up a project, these are the duties involved. Okay, you have to make the initial schedule, then update. So you talk about monitoring and updating the schedule throughout construction. Responsibility of the scheduling engineer. Okay, change orders, delays, other schedule disruptions. Schedule is going to be disrupted. How do you actually take care of all these disruptions? Okay, very critical. Scheduler works closely with the project manager, project execution team, and the subcontractors. If you don't do your job, they are all going to be kind of you're almost like the conductor of the orchestra. Okay, or you are writing all the scores so that the project manager can conduct the orchestra, but basically you are in the middle of this whole orchestra of a project. And one of the very, very critical abilities, you should be able to have good communication skills in addition to the knowledge and skills of scheduling tools. Okay, they will be continuously producing critical scheduling information for project team. So without the schedule is the backbone of the project. Without the schedule, the project is going nowhere, and the scheduling function becomes really, really the important part of this whole project management exercise. Okay, so it's support to project superintendent, project manager, and all other parties associated with the project. Without a good scheduling engineer, things don't go well. Now, when you look at the schedule, so we will take this up from the next class as to how we are going into the detail of scheduling. But when you look at a schedule, it is very important to understand scheduling can be done at different levels. So I want you to kind of look at this. So you have what we call an executive summary, okay, or master schedule. You have what is level 2 schedule, it's called a summary master schedule. Okay, you have project coordination schedule. Okay, and then when you go into level 4, you have the project working level schedule and a detailed schedule. Now, I leave it to you to go into the definition and look at it, but this is the basic framework for what we are going to be starting from the next lecture. But we will not be looking at all 5 schedules. We will primarily be looking at level 3 schedule, okay, which is where the critical path method is brought in a big way. But you have to understand that level 3 schedule has to interface with the other schedules, otherwise it's meaningless. Okay, that is now point 1. Point 2, can you think who would be the user for level 1 schedule, who would be the user for level 2 schedule?
So the owner will be for the level
1. Right, so higher you are in the project hierarchy or you know this thing, so typically the owner, okay, or what we talked somewhere, the regional manager from the contractor's point of view will be discussing level 1 schedule with the owner. What about level 2 schedule?
The project manager.
Right. So level 2 will be at the project manager's level. Okay. Level 3,
planning,
the scheduling engineer. He is primarily responsible for level 3 schedule, and this is where the all the nitty gritty details of the overall coordination plan is. Level 4?
Contractor.
contractors who would execute the review.
Yeah, so it's mostly the execution team. Yeah, so from level 4 it will be going to the execution team, and level 5 will be the detail at the craft level. They should know what the detail schedule is. So by going through these levels you also get an understanding that your organization of your project and your scheduling functions, they have to be correlated, okay, and without that you will not be able to, I mean you have to give the right report to the right person. If you give if you only schedule at level, I mean there I've seen projects where people try to schedule at level 4 throughout, saying more detail is better. Okay, you run into, you can't do level 4 schedules from the beginning because you cannot anticipate some of the activities required. Okay, at that level of detail. You can, you know, so up to level 3 is a must, right, at the beginning. But so level 4 and level 5, the details become as you look ahead. So another way to look at to classify these schedules is how much of a time period are you planning for? How frequently will the schedule change? So level 1 ideally should not change. Level 2, if there are major changes, might change. Level 3 has more chance of changing, okay, than level 2, okay, depending on major changes in the project requirements or unforeseen circumstances. What about level 4 and level 5? It can change, it can, yeah, monthly level, it can change, you know. So if you do a very detailed schedule, you know, level 3 and make it a level 4 detail, you are asking for trouble because it is going to change on you so much that just changing the schedule will be your full time job, okay. So we will, I might not get an opportunity to keep coming back to the scheduling levels, but this is something you have to keep in mind from a broad perspective. This is so important because a lot of times this is where scheduling does not get done properly. You have to produce the right schedule for the right requirement. Are there any questions?
So what is the difference between a PMC and a project manager?
A project management consultant, okay, is a person who is professionally, who is actually more representing the owner. So if there is a company that requires a construction service to be done, and that company does not have an in-house expert on construction of the facility, they will hire a project management consultant firm to be their representative to get that done. So the project management consultant will ensure that, you know, design is done properly, will coordinate between design and construction. They will take on that role. Project manager is just the person or the role who can, you know, so the owner might have a project manager to look after it, but it might be only his part-time job, okay. The contractor will have a project manager, but the project manager and consultant typically is the person who takes over the owner's interest in the construction project. I think that would be, in a summary form, that would be it, okay. So again, summarizing this lecture, we have covered this issue of how the construction industry is so important for national growth, and you know, why we nearly need to emphasize scheduling and other skills required for doing successful projects. We have looked at project stakeholders and how important stakeholder management is. We have looked at the different phases of a project, understood how projects are organized in a very broad context, and then looked at levels of scheduling and how they interface with a project organization to produce the right level for the right level of the organization. So we will continue next lecture in taking the basic concepts which drive the scheduling practice.